Hey everybody, some of you have asked for a demo of another noise reading decibel reader application besides the NIOSH app that I showed you in a video a long time ago. So I'm going to show you today an app that I prefer to use these days, especially for soundproofist videos. It's called Decibel Meter. And I'm going to run you through a demo of it today, some of the features that are in it, and some of the features that you don't get in the NIOSH app. Ready? Let's go. So the Decibel Meter app is available in the App Store. And there's a free version. It's free when you download it, but you can upgrade to premium for $2. And it's not an annual subscription fee either. It's a one-time fee, which I think is a really good deal. The developer's name is Ashraf Thapakudaval. So make sure you see this icon in the App Store because more than one app has the same name. This app is available for the iPhone and iPad, but I don't think it's available for Android. So let's take a look at the settings. First, you can set the calibration, and I've never done that. I just leave it at the default setting. Then you can choose the frequency weighting. And this app offers weightings of A, B, C, and Z. The default weighting is the A-weighted decibel. It's used in a lot of noise meters, and it's also used by the police when they're responding to a noise complaint. It's supposed to cover the range of the human ear, but the A weighting doesn't pick up very high frequency noise or very low frequency noise. Neither do our ears. And the B weighting is one that I haven't used before. But it supposedly covers the mid-frequency range, and it's said to be more sensitive to lower frequencies. It's not used much anymore, but it was once used by the motor industry, so that tells you something about the kind of noise that it picks up. The C weighting responds better to higher levels of noise and a wider frequency range. I always thought it responded better to lower frequency noise, and so I use it a lot instead of the A weighting. And the Z in Z weighting stands for zero frequency weighting. So I think that means that this is a flatter response across the whole audio spectrum. I don't use it myself. You can also toggle through these different weightings on the front panel of the app while you're using it. Next, you can set the threshold. And the range is from 60 decibels to 100 decibels in increments of 5 decibels. If you set the threshold lower, let's say to 60 decibels, whenever the noise level exceeds 60, you'll see the meter go yellow. And it's very easy to go over 60 decibels just from talking. I'll set it to 70. Enable recording turns on the microphone whenever you run the app, and the app will generate a record of the decibel levels on your phone. You can look at those records, or you can share them by email or social media. Here's an example of how a chart looks when it gets stored on your device. So it shows the decibel levels and the frequency levels. When you mail it, it will generate a document that details these readings in separate rows as opposed to a chart. The decibels reflect the loudness and the frequency is the type of noise, like if it's high pitched or low bass or in the mid-range. So the frequency reading of a bass tone might be about 60 hertz to 250 hertz. And the lower mid-range is 250 hertz to 500 hertz. Mid-range is 500 hertz to 2 kilohertz, and higher mid-range is from 2 kilohertz to 4 kilohertz. And you'll see in some of these examples that a lot of the sounds are in the bass range or in the lower mid-range, with a few higher frequency peaks when you hear a high-pitched car horn that goes over 3 kilohertz. I'm going to show you some examples using all three weightings. I'll play some sounds that I got from freesound.org, which are Creative Commons licensed sounds. You'll hear the same sounds at the same volume for all three tests. And I want you to keep an eye on how much the frequency levels change. The decibel reading is the big number in the middle, but the peak frequency reading is the smaller number just above it. So watch those numbers in the peak frequency section and the meter fluctuations that are in the half circle at the top of the app screen. You'll see that the car sounds might have a frequency of 150 or lower, but when a high-pitched horn honks, it goes all the way up into the thousands, like over 3 kilohertz. Let's start with the A weighting. Now, on to the bee waiting. And finally, my personal favorite, the sea waiting. So the results from these three weightings don't seem significantly different, but I think I saw slightly more range using the sea weighting. And just one more thing. I'm going to run a BAFX sound level meter side by side with the Decibel Meter app. The BAFX only measures A-weighted decibels. It's a very affordable meter that you can find on Amazon for about $20. I'll run it along with the Decibel Meter app, which is also set to A-weighted decibels. You'll see that the readings are similar, but not completely identical. I don't think the volume level in this test is exactly the same as the first test, but the point here is how a smartphone app is close in functionality to a dedicated sound meter. But in this case, the app has some extra perks. You can find the Decibel Meter app at the App Store for iPhone. Sorry that I don't have an Android to show you some Android-only apps. But if you want to recommend an inexpensive tablet that I can get for testing, go ahead and put that in the comments below. I could do that in the future. Thanks for watching, and remember, there's more information on noise and acoustics at soundproofist.com.